Pollination is the process of transfer of pollen from the anther to the stigma. For that particular reason, if the pollination is taking place between two flowers of complete two different plant, then we call this process a cross pollination. And it is this process which brings about a highest amount of variation in the offsprings that are going to be born out of them. Now, this process, it's not necessarily a process which is very likely to happen, but it does happen very frequently because this process is actually assisted by different type of agents. So there are various agents which are responsible for transfer of this pollen from the anther of one flower to the stigma of another. And all of those agents, they fall under the category of the agencies of pollination and are the one who are assisting in the process of this sexual reproduction in case of the flowering plants. To be very precise, it is a flower which has the intention of doing, like making those animal or making those agents do all of this. That's why the flower have undergone different kind of modifications and all. We will be talking about those modifications in a later video, but today our focus will be only to learn about these different varieties of the agents of pollination that actually exist. So very first one will be wind pollination. The wind pollination process, it is there from a very long time and has been in use for like in many of the species of the plant, where we find that it is just simply that the pollens get dispersed out in the wind, and then this pollen is then captured by the stigma. For that, a small modification that is usually seen is that the pollen is going to be dry. Dry comparatively, like it is not that moist that it is actually going to be having any hindrance in moving, but this one is able to go and is able to go and bind with the the stigma, which is usually something like feathery in shape. So the modification is there in the stigma part also, where the stigma itself is a feathery like structure and has got a much more chance of adhering the pollens to its surface. That's why all these plants will be seen that they readily catch the pollen which has been dispersed out in the wind, because this kind of pollination, it is completely under this completely under the grace of the wind, because the direction the wind is blowing, the pollen is going to flow in that particular direction. So the stigma needs to increase the chance of catching all those pollens out in the wind. That's why the structure, this kind of modification has been noticed. The very biggest example of this particular type of pollination can be the maize plant or the anything similar to that. We actually will find that should not stick to maize itself. Even grasses are also responsible for doing it. Many of the varieties of palm trees are also capable of doing it. The picture here shows that the dispersal of pollen by the anther of that particular flower or anther of the particular plant, and actually we can see here that is a kind of a dust. So it is this picture has been taken by using the light to illuminate only the pollen, because usually we won't be able to see it with our naked eyes due to the high contrast that it actually has all around, the glarity. This picture has been captured with the modified imaging technique. That's why we are able to see those small particles of those pollens are being dispersed from the plant. So next type can be definitely another abiotic mean, which is the water. Water is also playing a major role in the transfer, and it usually happens with the aquatic plant, clearly. So this plant, like the Vallisneria, it actually forms these two type of flowers, one the female, one the male. Now the male flower, they are born at the underwater, and whenever this pollination is supposed to take place, that time this flower is actually dispersed. Means the flower itself comes out. It is not that the plant is dispersing the pollen out like the previous case. Here the flower is actually coming out. And the flower, it comes on the surface because it is quite buoyant, so it will come to the surface and then will start flowing in the water current. So downstream, if there is any female plant there, then the swimmel plant will produce a flower which is going to be there, means it in a long stalk it will be born, and this flower will be there at the very top, above the water surface. So what will happen is the male flower will float in the water current, and then sun will come in contact with those female flower, and thus their reproductive part will come in contact and the pollination will take place. So this is an effective way of like reproduction, where the female plant definitely needs to stay downstream to that of the male plant, and this dispersal of flower is actually what is leading to the formation, like process of pollination. For this pollination to take place effectively, the male plant usually produces a very large quantity of flower. Like you can see, one image is shown here, where in the right hand side, though it's not in proper focus, but it is actually those flowers are floating on the surface and they are in large number that can be seen. And the stamens are well protruded outside, where it will which will have a greater chance of pollinating the stigma, because the moment it comes in contact with it, it will disperse the pollen, like all the pollens which are already there on the surface, and they will stick together, and finally the process will take place. Now the other means are the biotic agents, where like animals are actually being used for this entire process. So here we can see a primitive drawing representation is given here, where we can see that the plants are of two varieties, the male and the female, and they are like that. It's just because of that the two types of the reproductive rules are actually matured at a complete different time. So the first flower is where we can see that the anthers have completely matured and have dispersed the pollen, whereas the second flower, it has only the female part, the pistil, which is matured there. So in the first flower, the pistil is not matured, but the anthers are. The second flower, the anthers have already either withered away or is not matured at all, and the pistil is actually well matured. So what happens is, when the insect, they go there, here the example of the bees are being used, means way of insect pollination, you can say. So the bees are being are going there to collect the nectar, and that moment all these pollens are actually going to get dispersed on its body surface. So when it will go away from that particular flower and go and meet a female flower, so the female flower stigma will capture all those pollens, because it has already matured and has ready to absorb all these pollens to its surface, or ather all this pollen to its stigma. So that's why the pollination will take place. Here completely the animal is made to do that, because there is a nectar at the bottom which this animal wants to drink, and so it has come there to collect the nectar, and the pollination is taking place in that. In this particular way, by simple modifications of the flower, the plant is able to induce or make an animal do its bidding and take and disperse the pollen from one flower to the next. So this method is what is known as insect pollination, and they are called the entomophily method. So here you can see the image of that bee that was shown previously in a cartoonic manner. So here you see that the real image, where the pollen is completely covered the bee, its body surface, and so when it goes to another flower, it has pollinated it, because you can see the dispersal is taking place from there, from one to the next. So this is a way that is using insect to do the entire thing. Another way is definitely going to be the birds, because birds also are going to collect nectar from the plant. So the same way the birds are going to go, they are going to collect the nectar from the plant, and at that moment, exactly same manner, the entire process will take place, where the pollen will get dispersed to the body of the birds, and then the bird goes and touch a female flower, it will actually disperse it there. So this method will be called the ornithophily method, because of the use of birds here in the pollination. Another unique one is the use of bats, and that's why it's called the charypterophily. And this is actually at the baobab plant, the African baobab plant, Adansonia, as it is called scientifically. So this plant actually produces a large abundance of this flower, which this particular bat, they actually come to collect the nectar from the surface, and it's designed such a way that the entire stigma will actually, whatever will be there, will actually will take all those all of those pollens and will actually get fertilized, but just simply by the use of these bats. It will be discussed in a later video where we talk about the entire modifications that the plant they make in their body for this method. So there I'll show you the like cross section, how actually this flower actually appear and how they actually help in this process of pollination on making use of the bats. And the type will be snail, weirdly, but yes, snail is also there. Snail is also there sometimes, like they eat the actual petals of the flower. So they actually go up and into many of those plants, and for that particular like reach, when it is reaching those plants, actually the anthers are pollinating the surface, the skin surface of this snail, and thus the stigma will then, like in the next flower, the stigma will capture all that. So this is a use of snail, and it's called Malacophylli method. And definitely in this, among the insects, ants are very famous because they run everywhere, they go everywhere. So this method is simply transfer of pollens from like, or simple cross pollination by the help of this ants, different types of ants, and they are specified separately as Malacophylli method. Among the entomophili, because they are insects definitely, but they are said separately just because there is a huge abundance of plants. They actually are capable of doing all of that, all of those things, okay, because this particular insect, they are capable of pollinating and going every single places. So ants help everyone. Thank you.